Hello all, today we'll discuss how to create CAN DBC file. So let's start the session. Here I have opened vector CAN DBC editor. First of all, go into file. In file, you will see create DBC option. If you click on create DBC option, you will see different options for DBCs. So this many types of DBC you can create. Now we need to create for a CAN DBC. Then we can click on CAN template DBC. So basic template it will generate. First you need to give a name to your DBC. I will give demo CAN database. So basic template will be created. So in network you will see network name for which DBC file is created. Under this network you will see entire list of messages and signal. Right now we don't have created any message or signal, that's why this list is empty. You can edit this network by right clicking on this and click on edit network. In edit network you can select appropriate protocol as per your requirement. So right now we have clicked on CAN as we need to create a DBC for CAN protocol. Issue list is empty. Whenever we add node under this network node, then issue list also will be updated. We can see right now, right click on network node, new. In new we can give name as per our requirement. Now I am going to create DBC file for front door issue. So I will put name like front door ECU. Apply. Okay. Now I have created one node, that is front door ECU. In front door, transmit message and receive message list will be empty because we have not added any transmit message or receive messages. And accordingly, ECU list also get updated. Now we will create one signal first. Go on signal, right click and click on new. Then one dialog box will be open. Here in name you can give name to the signal. I will give name front door status. Right, front door status right. As this is for right door, I have given right over here. And length I will require 1 bit, as status will be open or close. Byte order is Intel. You can select as per your requirement Intel or Motorola. Value type will be unsigned because there will be only two values, 0 or 1, so I don't need any signed value or floating value or any other type of value. So factor will be 1 and maximum value will be 1. So no other information is needed right now. You can put any comment if you required. For example, status 0 stands for door open, 1 stands for door close. So I have created one signal over here. Similarly, I will add one more signal, front door status left. Similar to the right door, I will require 1 bit length. Byte order will be Intel only. Value type unsigned. Maximum value 1. And in comments, we can add whatever we require. At now, I will keep empty. These are the two signals I have created. Now, similar to the signals, I can create message over here on right clicking on message, new, we can view name according to our requirement, like front door status. After name there will be the type, so we can use standard CAN or extended CAN. I will keep standard CAN. ID, according to your requirement you can give any ID. Here I will give 111. Data length, here data length, as we have only two signals, so we can give data length 1 byte only. And transmitter and receiver will select afterwards. After that signals, in signal options we'll add whatever signals we require for this message. Here below you can see one option add. From this option you can add signals whatever you require. And after that there is one more option remove. If in list of signals you want to remove particular signal, then using this remove option you can remove the signal. We will have demo for both the option. So if I double click on add, then whatever signal list is available we can see over here. If I double click on particular signal, then that signal get added. Again, then remaining list will be shown. I will add second signal also. Now we will see how this remove option is worked. If I click on particular message, then this remove option will be enabled. Using this remove option I can remove particular signal if I am not required. If I click on remove, that signal get removed. Now I will add that signal again. Apply. Okay. Now I have created one message. Front door receive. So if you click on front door receive, then you will be able to see both the signals over here. If you double click on this signal, then you will be able to see detail of that signal. This is the message name, this is the signal name, and this is the start bit. So this signal will be start on 0th bit and multiplexing time. Similar for the next signal. If I double click on this signal, start bit for this signal is 1. That means this bit will be located on first position of the data byte. Here in message we can see layout of message also. By double clicking on it, there is one option layout. In layout we can see the layout of message. So 0th bit and first bit is occupied by these two signals. 0th bit is occupied by front door status left, first bit is occupied by front door status right. Now we have created two signals and one message. Now how to add this particular message under particular issue? You can add this message as a TX message or RX message. So I will add this message as a TX message for front door issue. Double click on message, go in transmitter. I will add. Here we can see the list of all issues. Right now we have only one issue, that's why one issue is there. Just double click on it, then the list of transmitter is updated. Apply. Okay. Here he is showing shall node still remain as a sender of the message. Say yes. Now this message comes under TX message list. Now we will see how to add RX message under this node. First of all we will create signals for RX message. Now we will create a signal for rear door issue. So right click, new. Similar to the front door, we will create signals for rear door. Rear door status left, length will be 1 bit, byte order Intel, value unsigned, and maximum value will be 1. So this is the signal created for rear door left side. One more for rear door, right side. Rear door. Rear door status right. Length will be 1 bit. Value type unsigned, maximum value 1. So this is how signal is created for rear door. Now we will create message for rear door issue. Go on message option, right click new. Similar to the front door, we'll create rear door status. CAN type will be the standard. ID we will create 0x112. Data length again 1 byte. This is enough. Rear door status message is created. We can edit this message to add list of signals. Right click, edit message, in signals, add. So whatever signal created for rear, I will add that. I can add 2 signals at a time by selecting both the signals. Okay. Here 2 signals get added. Apply. Okay. So here you will be able to see list of signals. So these are the signals, and here is the start bit. 0th bit will be for rear door status left. First bit will be rear door status right. We can check layout also. Here 0 bit is allocated for left door status, and first bit is allocated for right door status. Now we will add this message as a RX message for this issue. Double click on issue name and go into map RX signal. So in this option you will see add button over here. Using this button we will add list of RX signals. So here we are not going to add message directly, we are going to add signals whatever this node is going to receive. For rear door I have selected. Okay. Apply. Okay. Now RX messages get added under RX message list. So rear door issue, this message is added over here, and in mapped RX signal you will be able to see both the signals for RX. Similar for TX, there will be the list of TX signal for front door status left, front door status right. So this is how we can create multiple signals, multiple messages and nodes, and we can map RX message and TX message according to the nodes. And this is how we can create CAN matrix or DBC file for our network or for our node. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe.